Everybody loves you until you become competition to them. Everybody loves you until you become competition to them. Let me explain to you what I mean by this. Listen, in the world of business, in the world of sports, in any part where there is some sort of competition, there becomes a time when a new person comes on board, whatever it is, it's a company you're working in, it's your basketball team, it's your business industry, a new guy comes on board and all the other guys want to do whatever they can to help this new guy because they like him. No problem. And then this guy starts out training, out working, out improving, out studying. He becomes fully vested in wanting to become the best he or she can be. Then becomes the uncomfort zone. Let me explain to you what this is. It's when you suddenly start outperforming your teachers, your mentors, your older peers, people who were ahead of you, people who used to teach you a lot of the game, and you pass them up. And you know what happens? They get threatened by you. And typically when they get threatened by you, they respond to you in a few different ways. One of the ways they respond to you is, oh, I taught them everything, which is absolutely inaccurate because there's no way in the world somebody can teach you everything. Oh, I showed him the way, every way, everything he got us from me. It would be absolutely arrogant, conceited, and ludicrous for me to think I've taught you everything. And a lot of people say, Pat, without you, I wouldn't be where I'm at right now. It's not a lie. You did the work. You went out there and did the work. But some people take that approach. And then the other approach that some people take, they say, man, I am glad that I had a chance to put any kind of value into this person until they got to the next level. But the point I want to make to you is the following point. Look, if no one is threatened by you, if no one is sitting there saying, oh my gosh, this guy's coming up, you ain't really doing much for it. By the way, there's a lot of people that get afraid the moment competition gets tight and people start saying, oh, you this, they back down because they don't want to displease some of the people that taught them, because what if you pass them up? What if you do something bigger than them? Here's what happens. Let me explain to you a story here. I want you to think about, you're on the New England Patriots. Your name is Drew Bledsoe. Drew Bledsoe was a guy I liked. You're playing for Washington State before, now you're on New England Patriots. And all of a sudden you get hurt. And a guy comes in, I think he's 199 pick, Tom Brady. Do you think Bledsoe thought Brady was going to do anything crazy like he did? No. Do you think any of the guys that he played for in the past before, they want to say, well, you know, Washington State, it's because of me why Brady is who he is, because I'm his high school coach, I'm his college coach, and everybody wants to take credit? No. The mature coaches say, it was just great having experienced the time that we had together to be able to contribute to this person's success. That's what a mature leader would do. But whether they do it or not, a Brady is going to do what Brady's going to do, because there's one thing no one knows about. No one knows what you're thinking about here. No one knows what time you come in the morning. No one knows what time you go to sleep at night. No one knows what you're reading. No one knows the strategies. No one knows the effort. No one knows how hard you're working. No one knows it except for one person, and that's you. Everybody else gets upset. So my challenge to you is, as you're watching this, who's threatened by you? Who? Is anybody? Or are you just a nice guy that no one's threatened by? You're the nice girl that no one's threatened by? Because the reality part of it is, when you do decide to play big, guess what? There's going to be a moment where some of the people that used to be supportive, some of the people that used to like you a lot, may start not liking you, and that's okay.